pretty mechanic, a shy doctor, a turmoil of emotions. Mechanic Virginia Lawson Smith, beloved wife of master janitor Barney Weber, has been happily married for more than 6 months. However, as her marriage grows towards antiquity, the five-figure income and two-figure gifts of her husband become insufficient for her fiery and practical spirit. Intelligent Martin Brown, a doctor of chemistry at the local university, divides his time between his highly popular and highly expensive lectures and walking alone through the woods near the cabin of the town founders. Hiding behind his thick lenses and bashful face are a handsome face and a desire to please. One billowy summer evening found Mrs. Smith walking home to what she knows will be an empty house. Barney works night shifts on weekends. To her surprise and secret delight, Mr. Brown walks out of the forest and shyly presents the beautiful mechanic with a dazzling necklace. The ornaments of this jewelry are the chemical structures of alcohols, isopropyl, encrusted with topaz, acetone layered with emeralds, and most stunning of all, ethyl alcohol bathed in the light cast by glittering rubies. The young doctor finds the mechanic happily through the town, passing a muralist, glancing toward the school where her husband works, and sighing at the sight of the university. Under her coat, she wears a light sundress, tastefully embroidered with the true love meanings of evaporation factors. She's carrying a can of ethyl alcohol, which she plans to have converted to ethanol for an engine experiment. Burdened with chemicals and a heavy burning heart, she paced through the grove in hopes of seeing the doctor. To her joy, he is leaning against the cabin door, looking splendid in contact lenses which make his eyes red and watery. He gestures her inside to a completely upkept living room in historical accuracy. Overcome with passion, she flings all of his gifts to on the floor and betrays her marriage on the soft sofa. Too late, thoughts of her wedding vows arise to haunt her. Fleeing the scene, she guiltily douses the place in accelerant and torches the evidence of her sin. Dr. Brown ran out of the burning building, his mind blanking to protect itself, and reverting to his default state. He went on to his next chemical demonstration. Virginia hid in her mechanic's clothes, and her life went on.
Hello?
Agent Jobrak, this is the Chief of Police. The Town Founder's cabin just burnt down. Arson is strongly suspected. We need you on the case. Can you be there?
I think I can. So this is the crime scene.
Golly gee willikers! That's amazing!
Guys, I can barely bear the intenseness of this sight.
Boom, bap.
Stop that!
I guess that makes me hydrogen.
Why?
Because I'm the number one element.
Actually, Steve, you're more of a boron.
Shut up!
That over there.
Go.
I'm gonna get a sample.
Agent Jobrak, what's this?
What?
It's deer shit, Steve.
Agent Caulfield, help me search for evidence.
What is this stuff, anyways?
Uncheck, sir. It appears to be cinders.
Cinders? What would cinders be doing on a crime scene?
I think that's about all we can do here, agents.
Our work here is done.
Where is he going?
Later, at the mobile lab.
Sorry I'm late, guys. I couldn't find where you parked the mobile lab.
That's alright.
I think we should start testing the evaporation rate on this accelerant. Is that okay with you guys?
It's a good plan.
Okay, let me test it. smells really bad. I need to see you afterwards.
It's really unprofessional behavior.
I'm the chief. I define professional behavior.
Whatever. Okay. I got it. Let me just evaporate it.
Thanks, chief.
And what have you been doing this whole time?
Leading.
Well,
I am a leader.
Hey, chief. Take a look at this.
Looks just like the graph of ethyl alcohol. The starting and ending temperatures are the same, and the general shape is the same.
That's exactly what I thought.
Me too.
Good work, men.
And women.
Next time on CSI Sunbury.
Hello?
Hey, this is the police chief. Agent Jobrak, there's just been an accident on Old 3C. Reckless driving is strongly suspected. Can you take the case?
I think I can. Quick, Steve! To the mobile lab! Steve! Help, help. I'm a prisoner in a Chinese cookie factory. No, I'm just kidding. It says focus on your long-term goal. Success is soon yours.
Steve, what does yours say?
Mine's really stupid. You know, it's never find your delight in another's misfortune. What's that supposed to mean? Like, I'm gonna laugh at somebody's house that just burned down?
It's ethyl alcohol. Now, don't you wish you'd read this before you did the test?
What else do I have in the back of the truck? This graph, it slopes down quite dramatically. Here, take a look at it, Chief.
It looks just like our graph for methyl. It's the exact same shape, the parabola.
Methyl?
Methyl alcohol. M-E-T-H-Y-L.
I can spell perfectly fine. You know what? I'm sick of your attitude. Let's take this.
Stop recording, because
you're supposed to say...
Yeah, be gone with you.
What?
Boom.